we received an interesting letter from James B. Mm-hmm. He writes, guys, a couple of weeks ago, you discussed the issue of deliberate ball handling. Mm-hmm. Well done. I liked it very much. Mm-hmm. I play grade cricket and recently saw this incident on YouTube. Can we just roll the tape here? Bowler comes in. Batsman whacks the ball. Now, the ball deflects. Keeper takes the catch.
Now, is that out?
Yeah. Well, the umpire calls a dead ball there, so...
Okay. So he's fine now. We know the bowler's fine.
He should have called dead bowler. No, that bowler is all right, let's be honest. That man is all right.
Well, here we go. I'm not... Well, James keeps writing. I'm not sure the ump got it right when he called it a dead ball. What do you guys reckon? Well, James, that's a very interesting question. We feel totally out of our depth, so we thought we'd get the opinion of an expert. Mm-hmm.
Mr. Siddle, you have seen the facts. What is your considered opinion?
A curious case indeed. Law 23, paragraph 1b states, a ball shall be dead when it is clear that the fielding side and the batsman have ceased to regard it as in play. The fielding side clearly did not. Ergo, the ball was still in play. However, Law 23, paragraph 4b states, it may be considered dead if a player is injured. Prima facie, the umpire is right. His ratio decidendi is sound, but his decision was ex post facto. In my opinion, his decision was not stare decisis, and clearly ultra vires. There can only be one conclusion. I hope I've been of assistance.